Hi guys, so I'm Claude, I'm from Fauna Marine, and today we want to talk a little bit about the issues which the aquarium world worldwide has actually with the bacterial disease and ciliates on acropores, on montiporous, sometimes on euphilias. And we want to show you today from our quarantine section how it looks like, what we can do against this, and where all these comes from. Let us go directly in. Today we stay at the Fauna Marine Coral Farm. As one of the only supplier of dry goods and care systems for the reef tanks, we own our own coral farm. This is this place where we develop the products, where we test the products, where we test our ICP. There we take care that our products are working properly under conditions which are more worse or more difficult for the corals as in your reef tank at home. One of the systems is our quarantine systems, where all the corals come in, where we have difficulties, we see, maybe they're not that good, or maybe they have something, so immediately they come out of the farm, coming in this quarantine section, where we take care of them, or we let them stay for several weeks, and find out how we can treat them, how we can get them back to a real nice coloration and grow. Maybe some people which know the farm here from Europe, which are visiting us, are wondering why we have a lot of big colonies and broodstock cords even in the quarantine section. The reason for that is that we need healthy animals which are strong and have a resilience against all the parasites and acropores and have a proper and healthy microbiome. That means that they have a good bacteria situation, because these bacteria also go to other cords then during the way they're in. The next step is, on the growing cords, I can see the water quality. I can use the test, can see on the cords if they grow, I know the water is okay. Cause when I have a damaged cord, a cord which is ill, which don't grow, it looks like that the water can be bad. So it's not sure at the first view what it is. If you have a little bit experience about corals, and I work with corals now since the year 84, you can see immediately what corals have, how they look like, if they have not the coloration, if the fluorescence is not like that, if the skin is pale, or they have some little mucus stuff on it, like you can see here on the blue stackhorn, which I can show you now, which have a bacterial disease. Maybe it's a vibrio disease, or it's acrobacteria, or a mix on it. We just check these with genetical studies, what they have exactly. So at the moment, when we have such corals which are coming from imports or from farms, whatever, we find very often a vibrio disease. And usually it will be treated with different types of antibiotics. The problem in Europe, and especially in Germany, is that the usage of antibiotics is forbidden. We cannot buy them, we cannot use them. We need doctors, we need special papers for that if you want to do that, and you need a veterinarian doctor which writes you the prescription for that. Here in this case, we have this situation which makes actually a lot of problems. So we try to find out a solution how to get rid of these issues without using these medicines, antibiotics, which are not available in Europe as a little bit different as in the States. The usage of antibiotics in a reef aquarium is also not that easy. It is dangerous for the environmental, and you have to handle it correctly. The problem of this is that when we doing a treatment with antibiotics in the aquarium and we give it then later the water out, we creating bacteria, a resilience of bacteria which can harm us humans also. So for that, it's not a good idea to go every time with an antibiotics inside the aquarium. The same reason is that we don't treat only the bacteria which we want to treat, we treat also our good bacteria and the bacteria on the cord, which is the fact is that they get faster ill as before. Usually this type of illness of corals is not harmed every coral in the aquarium, only a few ones, and they're good to see. If you take them out of the aquarium, you make a dip with the silly dip assembler. It needs only 60 to 90 seconds. Then you can put them back. And usually after one, sometimes you need two treatments, the ciliates and the bacteria are gone and the cores can heal and will not affect anymore any other cores in the system. If you check at the same time your ICP test and you take care that your halogens like fluorine, bromine and iodine gets in the right relation and the right levels, then the reinfecting will not happen. And that's the point where we go to. The second thing is, which is really important, is that if you buy cores, then take care that you have a small quarantine section. Take care that you put the cores in the quarantine section in and let them stay there for 3-4 weeks. Have a look on them, and when they look shiny, polyps are out, the skin is not pale, it's shiny, and they have growing tips, then you can put them into the tank. And it doesn't matter if you dip them, to be sure, one time. If you dip cores all the time with oily solutions, then you destroy also the bacteria on the skin, on the cores, and also it cracks the skin, so which makes it for parasites easier after to come to the core. So take care not to dip too much. Quarantine station, look on the cores. If they are good, then you can dip one time to be safe. And then in the reef tank, that's okay. If you dip 3, 4, 5, 6 times with very aggressive solutions, this become very dangerous for you. The other thing is, and that's something special for my US friends, there's one thing, and I will say this today. Some of you, I find out, or we see, we learn, that they dip with a bio solution, which is a pesticide. And this pesticide contains neurotoxins. These neurotoxins you bring in the aquarium and to the aquarium water, going through the skimmer, and with all the small particles and all the salt dust which you find in your house, is all this pesticide in your house. I would not recommend to use such dips. They're effective, they work really great, I know that, but they stay on the coral in a really, really high amount, and you bring it back to your living room. And I don't know if that's a really good idea. Please think about it, because in my opinion, neurotoxins or toxins has nothing to do in the living room with kids and other people running around. So we make a solution for you. That's a silly dip. And if you have any questions about illness of cores and how we treat them without using antibiotics, without using dangerous chemicals, then contact us under support at phonomarine.de or read the HDU, the how to use the products what we have, and I can promise you it will work. We are finished for today. See you later for the next video, and bye-bye. I think maybe I was a little bit too fast with my end, because there is the marketing directors which push me now to make a little bit advertising. It's a good idea when you do the treatment and to make a reconvalescence for your cores, that they get more strong and then they build a nice bacteria and get back and growing. So you can use this product from us, which calls Recon X, coming from reconvalescence. A few weeks after you do the treatment, you can do it in an aquarium. It contains herbal extracts and organic compounds who helps the coral to fight against the rest of the parasites or the rest of the bacteria and bring them back to good growth and a very nice coloration. The marketing is gone, so we can stop our video. Many thanks for the view for our videos. Like I say, if you have any questions, come back to me. We're always happy to help you and to give us more ideas about successful reef keeping. Bye-bye, have a good day. Thanks a lot.